there are these things called fish ladders. So early in the 20s and 30s, they started taming out a lot of rivers and creeks and streams for water spots for cities. Now that it's 80 years later, we have larger reservoirs and better systems. Fish can't spawn because there's a dam in the way of where they're trying to go. So what they've started doing is constructing fish ladders. Every fisherman has a story of the big one that got away. I had hooked on to probably close to a 40-inch striped bass up in the bay. I'm fighting it for a few minutes. It's peel and drag. It's really good fight. You get it close to the boat, I can finally see the fish. And the fish looks me in the eye, shakes his head, the hook pops out, and then he's gone.
We often say here in Audubon, we're for Audubon Rockies, part of the National Audubon Society, that birds are indicators. You know, they're going to tell us when something is going right or is going wrong in our environment. And I think it translates over to, you know, human health as well, what's going right and what's going wrong. What we're looking at in migration of people, I think it's getting harder for people to move around the world, to move within our country, you know, just based on socioeconomic availability. And the same is going with birds.
It not only retains water, but it also collects anything from the uplands that washes in. So if we left tumbling meadows alone, it would fill in and become a wet meadow over time, and then progress to a dry meadow, and then on its way to being a deciduous forest. We embarked upon this big, huge restoration project that seeks to stop it as a freshwater non-tidal